Welcome you all to day 3 of certificate course on computer basics and MS Office from basic to advanced. Okay. Today we will be learning Windows 7. Okay. But before learning Windows 7, there are some upgraded things that we should know. What added on features are there in Windows 7 as compared to Windows XP and somewhere Windows Vista? Some people might have heard about Windows Vista, but commonly used was Windows XP. Okay, so you will find that jo hum logon ne Windows XP mein taskbar ya system tray dekha tha, so that is a different one. The look wise, they are different. Some added on functionalities are there. Okay. Now, one more quick desktop view button is added in Windows 7. As far as startup, sleep, and resume performance timing is there. Startup means just when you put on the computer and your operating system gets loaded and you are ready to work on it, is the startup. The sleep time is you are making the computer in a sleep mode, and resume performance time is by wake up button, you are making the computer again work for it. And also these days you will find your computer is having that mechanism, or you can say the hardware mentioning like it saves the battery, it saves the memory, and it consumes less power as compared to the previous versions. So also the Windows that we are using also takes care of how to improvise the power management. And there are many libraries for good file access and organize the files on your computer. Okay. Now, apart from this, there is one action center mentioning whether you are downloading something or taking the backup of something, or there is some troubleshooting going out, or some pop-ups are there mentioning like some updates are to be taken care of. So it takes under Action Center. Then some user account customization of notifications are available. You can take the backup in very good way as compared to XP and Vista in Windows 7. Apart from this, there are very new good wallpapers and themes. Some gadgets are there. What are gadgets? They are like a softwares. Just you plug in and they are on. Okay. So these type of gadgets are of good functionalities in Windows 7. There are many new games also, like Chess Titans. I'm not well versed with Mahjong Titans and Inkball. There are also in Windows XP, you will find a simple calculator, but in Windows 7 onwards, you will find a advanced calculator function having, it can save the history that whatever the series of calculations you are doing, they can be saved. Apart from this, there is like network key, in which if you are passing the information across the network, you can have that key to be taken care of. Also, like suppose I am just plugging my phone, okay? So the moment I plug in the phone, it asks me, or it can show me two options. One, my phone is having camera, so it will show me either I can use the camera of my phone. Second, there are photos or files in my phone. So do I just have to transfer it like any other USB drive? So this type of its feature is available, that is called as device stage. Then Windows Mail is replaced by Windows Live. Now, what are the, abhi hum logo ne Windows XP padha hai last class mein. So क्या नया है यहाँ पे? स्टार्ट आइकन नया है. आपको जो लुक है उस लुक में, जो विंडोज का लुक है उस लुक में आपको तीन चीजें अलग अलग वैरायटी से दिखेगी. वन इज एरियो स्नैप, वन इज शेक, एंड थर्ड वन इज पीक. देयर आर डेस्कटॉप आइकन्स लाइक कंप्यूटर एंड माई डॉक्यूमेंट्स. नाउ दे आर एक्सेस थ्रू स्टार्ट मेनू. अर्लियर वर्जन्स दे वर लुकिंग लाइक अ आइकन ऑन द डेस्कटॉप. लार्जर आइकन्स एंड हिडन आइकन्स इन टास्क बार, यू कैन मैनेज देम. देन देर इज क्विक लॉन्च toolbar wherever. If we want to pin some programs, they are every time needed. You can pin those programs and reuse in taskbar. So these are the added versions. Then jump lists are available for easier access. What are jump lists that I have shown you in previous XP classes? There we find in the taskbar if a folder having one icon embedding list of files of similar type. So that is the jump list for easier access. Then we can search through startup menu, and the run option is available also on the search bar, and it helps you to create many faster and smoother gaming components. The best part of Windows 7 that I use is parental controls for monitoring computer use. I set up some of the things that my children should not access. So this is the best feature of Windows 7 and 10 I'll be using at my home. Update features that eliminates web surfing from patches. Now, what better features, or what are the specific features that we can see or rely on Windows 7 are? It decreases the startup and shutdown. Now see, as far as we are working on the computer, we might not just calculate 20 seconds, or maybe 20 seconds are not that much important for the new beginners. But if you are a regular user, if you want to put on the computer, then if it takes long time, you will have a rigidity for it. But nowadays, Windows 7 and 10, you will observe, they start up very fast, and as well as they shut down very fast. Sleep and resume is faster. They use less memory. Pop-up results very fast. What type of results? Whatever you search on it. Then you can reconnect to your wireless network. Friends, at the start of the class, or before starting the class, my laptop was attached with a Wi-Fi router. But I identified that it is not giving a proper signal. So instantly I switched over on my phone network, that is hotspot. So without you feeling the shift from one network to other wireless network, the things were managed. So this is the feature of Windows 7. Then it recognizes USB devices faster. I hope you all are getting the features of Windows 7. So these are the additional features: device stage, Windows Live Essentials, Home Group, Windows Touch, and remote media streaming. If you are having a computer that is of touch screen, you can monitor Windows Touch just by clicking and monitoring and zooming. You can just manage all sort of shift between the various windows. Okay, if you want to play YouTube or some song, or some live session from some, you can say, any link or YouTube or Facebook. So you can just do it. Or if your computer is connected to anybody else's computer, you can manage it. Friends, now we'll start up with Windows 7 desktop. Okay. So the moment you start, Windows XP and 7, both are same. A minor variations are observed as far as the GUI is concerned. Okay, so this is the desktop. These are icons. This is for recycle bin. This is for my pictures. Like we can say it as a folder. Then this view is for, see here, my pictures. It is containing the window mentioning where it is located, a search bar, the icon-wise display of the file contents of my pictures, the navigation window mentioning where it is, which drive it is, what are the various libraries, what are the, this is for quick access. Instantly we can go for it. You are saying recent places here. So if your file is recently open and you don't have to go and search to the all the places, just click on recent places and you will get the latest file you have seen or viewed. So now from your desktop, these are the components. These are icons. Here the start button is different. It is like a Windows flag button. Okay, so how you will locate your start button? It will be viewed as your a circle having a flag. Okay, and next to it, it is having a long bar. This is called as taskbar. Okay, the empty space on the desktop is actually the desktop area, or you can say the desktop background. Okay, there we can work. जब भी हमको कोई राइट क्लिक ऑप्शन करना है या कोई अदर ऑप्शंस वर्कआउट करना है तो हम ये एम्प्टी स्पेस में काम करेंगे. अदरवाइज विल यूज द आइकन्स वेर एवर वी आर नीडिंग फॉर. लाइक इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गो टू कंट्रोल पैनल विल डबल क्लिक दिस. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ओपन एमएस ऑफिस एंड दैट टू पावर पॉइंट विल ओपन दिस. फॉर वर्ड विल ओपन दिस. फॉर माई कंप्यूटर आई विल ओपन दिस. इफ आई एम एडमिन एंड वर्किंग लाइक file folder, I'll open this. This is my recycle bin. So likewise, I'll just click on the icons and work on it. Okay, so now friends, this is a home group, admin, computer, network, and control panel. These are just the examples of various icons that we see. This is the folder view. This is my computer that was there in Windows XP. Okay, this is home group. If your computer is interconnected through intranet, then you will see your computer placed in home group. On the network where it is, which type of network it is configured with, and all those things. In control panel, you have the access and you can manage your computer through this control panel. Now we have seen this taskbar. This bar is called as taskbar. Now in this taskbar, this portion, this much portion is called as quick launch bar. Okay, this is called as quick launch bar and this is notification bar. Okay, in this notification bar, you can see your volume button, or you can say action center button, and many more. If your computer is connected on the this thing network, you will see this type of icon. Okay, so this is your start button, this is quick launch bar, and if you want to set up date and time, just double click on the date and time, or somewhere it asks for right click and then it pop ups the menu, and there it shows adjust date and time. So you will have to do appropriate settings. Now friends, in the taskbar, you will see this is that arrow mode I have discussed with you. Now see, this is a type of file. This is a type of file. And suppose this file is having three files opened. So you will see this. The moment I bring my mouse pointer here, you will be able to see these three files. So just by moving the cursor, mouse pointer, and clicking on the appropriate file, you can open it. Next is, if I require every time the program, like suppose I'm playing a solitaire game and I want every time that it should be handy for me. So what I'll do, I'll pin that program. How can I do? I'll open it and click pin to taskbar. So you will see my that program is available here. This is my pin to taskbar. So it will be there like this in taskbar. Okay. If my work is over now, I'm not regularly or recurringly requiring that program again and again. What I'll do, I'll unpin the task, this program from the taskbar. Okay. Now, in one more view, you will find, see, these are the stacked one. These are the stacked one. So how will you notice or know that more than one program of that particular file is open? See here, more than one file of Internet Explorer is open, more than one folder is open, but only one media file is open, only one solitaire is open, only one control panel is open. So the stacking of icons can be a hint for you to identify the things. Okay. Now, if I want to show the jump in list, that yes, what are the frequently used programs that are there? So I'll click on the folder and see, this is the quick list that is available. So from this, I'll just click on this suppose and I'll get the things easily accessible. I hope everyone is getting. You can post S for yes and no, N for no. Either you can post Y or yes for S, yes, and N for no. Wherever you don't understand, please post no. Then how to set the date and time. When I click on this, you will find my this type of screen is available. Now here I'll have to change the date and time. So how will I adjust it? When I'll click on change date and time. From that change date and time, I'll select the appropriate date and appropriate time by selecting either AM and PM, the hours, the minutes and seconds. And finally, I'll click on OK and either apply or OK directly. Friends, many times it happens if you are having a change in your system time and actual time, then there may be a conflict with when your file is being created or accessed and where actual date will be a conflict. So please take care of that your system date and system time should be a accurate one. Okay. Now, in the Action Center on the desktop, we have seen, if I see, when I click on start, this type of things are accessible. And on the taskbar, I find a flag button. This is called as Action Center. Friends, whatever is a whatever updates are being installed or any antivirus is required or any sort of some important messages are there, they are reflected over here. Okay. Now, next we have discussed with respect to gadgets. Okay. So now for these gadgets, friends, like suppose you want a calendar or a clock or a CPU meter or a currency converter or weather information gadget. Likewise, you can place on the desktop screen and it will help you to get the information like we do on our phones. Okay. So they are like the same one. Now, friends, how will you have your own configuration for your background that you view when your computer is on? Okay. Like when we start our phone, if we see our personal photos or some ritual photos or some photos that we believe in, okay, might be some God or some your good quotes. So we keep it as our wallpaper or a background. Okay. So same settings you can do over for your computer or your laptop. Okay. So now what we will do in the blank area that we have discussed earlier, that blank area will click right click, and just when you right click, you will see a pop-up window like this. Okay. अब ये जो पॉपअप मेनू आया हुआ है उसमें से आप पर्सनलाइज ऑप्शन सिलेक्ट करेंगे. ओके, व्हेन यू विल सिलेक्ट दिस पर्सनलाइज ऑप्शन, यू विल बी एबल टू व्यू दिस टाइप ऑफ स्क्रीन. हियर यू कैन सी ऑल द डिटेल्स. ओके, दे आर वेरी इजी. प्लीज डोंट पैनिक नॉर कंफ्यूज योरसेल्फ. देर आर फोर सेटिंग्स दैट यू कैन डू ओवर हियर in the personalized section. First is desktop background. Suppose I need to have my own photo or my son's photo in the desktop as a background. Whenever I put on my computer, I'll be able to see his photo. So what I should do, I'll click on desktop background. Then I'll click on the photo that I require for. So there, I'll select that photo and set as desktop background. So the moment I'll click on this, then it will ask me whether to fill it, tile it, or center it. Fill means the entire screen will be full with the feature. Second, tile means if the picture is small, so the screen is full with many replications of that picture. And center means the image will be placed at the center of your screen. So as per your need, you can set it. Then next is, we'll see how to set our screensaver. Friends, screensaver is a helpful tool if you want to save the, you can say, either battery or power consumption. It saves the refresh rate of your screen also. Okay. One incident, it happened with me. I'll just share it with you. One of my friend's college was having one function, and there the children have drawn a very beautiful rangoli. And as it was a computer day, computer science day, some likewise, so they have created a laptop in rangoli and a screen mentioning welcome. Okay, now my friend's daughter, she viewed in the rangoli and said, auntie, इसमें मिस्टेक नहीं दिख रहा आपको? मैंने कहा, क्या बेटा, क्या दिख रहा है मिस्टेक? सो शी सेड, डेस्कटॉप पे तो आइकन्स होते हैं ना? आई सेड, यस, आइकन्स तो होते हैं. फिर यहाँ तो दीदी भूल गए निकालना आइकन्स. मैंने कहा, यू आर राइट बेटा, आइकन्स तो होते हैं, बट अगर आपका स्क्रीन सेवर ऑन है तो क्या ये आइकन्स दिखाई देते हैं? एंड हर क्वेश्चन वॉज सॉल्व. Her doubt, her wrong perception was clarified there. While you are having the screensaver, you don't see the icons. Okay? So how will you put the screensaver? From that personalization window, you will select, right now here none is there. When you will click on this, you will have the option here. See, so many options are there. So from these so many options, I'll select 3D text. And the moment I select 3D text, by default, the welcome text is there. If I want, I can put my name also there or anybody else's name. So it will just toggle out and show in a 3D view. Okay. We can set the delay timings. Wait up to 50 minutes. Or whenever, you can just press any key. Okay. Next is how we can set the colors. Your theme, your color of your window should be of what type, what color. You can set it here from this particular color blocks. You can create your own color also here by managing the brightness, by managing the sensitivity. Okay. Next, friends, this is very important settings in fonts. Suppose you are using a normal English font, then no issue. But if you are using any regional font, how will you install it in your computer? So you'll download from the net, okay, and save it in your folder, that is fonts folder. On C drive, you'll locate your fonts folder and you will copy and paste it there. But just copy pasting will not make your font workable. How will you work on it? You will have to, from the search bar in the start menu, you will have to type and select the specific font. When you will select the font, you can click on it and that particular name will appear over here. And it will be now in use. Likewise, otherwise it will not be used. Okay. Same, you can change the font size. If you want to make your screen user friendly. So what happens if my fonts are very small? It becomes very strenuous for me to read it. And if they are very large, my neighbor will read it. So somewhere we need to balance it. So by default, generally we have smaller fonts. But if you have some screen issue, so I'll recommend you, you should use either medium or larger fonts. Okay. Then suppose you want some default fonts to be kept off with no formatting and nothing, just pure fonts. So there you will have to adjust the clear type. So these type of options will be available in front of you. And from those font settings, you can click on clear type and adjust the clear type. Okay. Now, next very important topic that we will be studying in Windows XP is if we, in Windows XP, we used to use one user or two users or many users. Okay. In Windows 7 also, we can use many users. Okay. So how to manage them? How to manage a multiple user account? So how to create it? So what you will do? You will go to control panel. Okay. And from that control panel, you will go on user accounts. Okay. And from that user accounts, you will click on add or remove user accounts. Okay. The moment you click on add or remove user accounts, you will see how many names are there. They are as user accounts. Okay. Now, here, generally, we have one administrator account. When we install Windows, we have one account as an administrator account. Friends, it is my suggestion and recommendation to you. Please don't give password to the admin account. Second, create your own guest account, which is different from administrator account. And in case if you forget the password that you have given to your own account, you can get the access and clean up the password from the administrator account. But if you give the password to the administrator account, it becomes a very difficult task to regenerate that password. Okay. So now how will we create an account? If I want to modify this account, I'll click on this. But if I want to create a new account, I'll click on this. Okay. So when I click on this, a name is there. Here I can put a create new account and click on this. Jo naam main yahan pe dungi, aap yahan pe set kar sakte, whether it is a standard user or an administrator. Because if you are working with some programs, you need to have work with the administrator, or in general you can use as a standard user. So here I'll put the name and click on create account. Then suppose I need to manage a password. Here both I'm not changing. Here guest, there is no password. Now for this particular account, I need to change the password or create a password. So what I'll do, I'll click on this and click on edit. So the moment I click on edit, it will pop up me with these options. What I have to do, I'll have to create it, create a password first. So I'm creating a password here, making it password protected. Here it will ask me to type a new password. I'll type that password. Again, I'll retype that same password. If both passwords match, then only will be able to go for next stage. If there is any discrepancy, it will show an error. Okay. If I forget to remember the password, sometimes I need a hint. So I'll put that hint here. If I forget the password, I'll put that hint here. There is one joke. Once Santa used to, every time he used to forget the password. He never remembered the password. But he every time typed the correct password. How is it possible? Whenever he used to type something, the message used to follow, your password is incorrect. Then he used to remember INCORRECT. And he used to type it and get the things done. Okay? Now, if I want to change the look of this particular icon, sometimes we need to have our profile pic, like we have our DP on WhatsApp. So we can change the picture. Click on account and click on change the picture. From these very details, you can select any type of your favorite picture, or you can select or create your own one from this browse option. And when you select it, click on change picture. Now, friends, we'll see what is Windows Explorer. This yellow folder icon that is located on the taskbar. This yellow folder is your either library or you can say Windows Explorer. The moment you click here, you will see a categorize. Like we have our albums on our phone. Here also there are categories that we call it as libraries. Documents, pictures, music, and videos. So by default, they are like documents will go to documents library, music will go to music library, pictures will go to pictures library, and videos will go to videos library. So these type of files are grouped together by default under these names, like my documents, my music, my pictures, my videos in Windows XP are renamed as documents, music, library, pictures. Okay, they both are same. Libraries mein aap usko documents, music, picture or videos bol sakte ho. Aur agar folders ke perspective mein main agar usko screen pe dhoondna chahu, to mujhe kya dikhenge? My documents, my music, my pictures, my videos. Okay? Now how to find a file? Okay? Suppose I have opened pictures. So there I can see directly. Suppose I want to search a waterfall picture. So directly I'm going to libraries, pictures, my pictures. There I'll see the list. Okay? So this is one way of finding a file. I'm knowing where that file is. Okay? But there are chances that I'm not knowing, but I'm knowing the name of it. So suppose I'm knowing the name that some Africa file was there. Now, how I'll search for it? So in the search bar, I'll just type AFRICA, okay? And it will show me the list mentioning the Africa. These are the results, okay? Likewise, you also can find your files. If you want more advanced versions of your file, you're not knowing the name, but you remember, suppose you are searching for some yellow flowers. The file name is Tulip, but you are searching for it, okay? So what you will do, in the tags you find, they are flower and yellow. So likewise, you can go and search for it, okay? You can add on the details also to a particular image so that wherever required, you can make the search more faster, okay? Next, suppose my search value is having wildlife. So see, directly it will show me wildlife file. One more thing, I remember the date that I have created a file. But right now I'm not remembering the name nor the location. So what I'll put here, date created, and select the appropriate date, okay? Also, you can select the range also by putting two dots in between the two dates. Two specific dates, if you are knowing that your file is being created or modified between the two specific dates, you just put two dots in between the two dates, you will get that range. You know, you should, by virtue of practice, you will be able to customize your search. Okay. After showing the listing, the list will be displayed in very variety of views. That is extra large icons. Suppose images are there. So before opening the image, just by looking through extra large icons, you will able to identify, yes, what photo this is. Like this is of desert, this is of penguins, and likewise. Okay. Extra large means a screen will have only 3 or 4 icons. Large icons might be at the size of your thumbnail. Medium icons, maybe small. Then small icons, only icons will be there. Then list, just all complete names will be there. Details will have the name list followed by the description of that particular file. And likewise, there are variety of views available. So you can toggle or access any view as per the selection by this button. Okay. Now, if you want to search from a start menu, how will you search? When you click on start button, you will find a box here. So you can type the name over there and you can search it. Okay. One more thing, as we have discussed earlier, from the start menu, you can see documents, pictures, and music. Okay. If your file is created and it is not saved by your choice, then it is saved by default. Okay. So by default, the file is saved in. जब भी मैं कोई स्पेसिफिक पाथ नहीं देती हूँ तो बाय डिफॉल्ट वो फाइल जाके सेव होती है. अगर वो इमेज फाइल है तो वो पिक्चर्स में जाके सेव होगी. अगर वो वीडियो फाइल है तो वो वीडियोस में जाके सेव होगी. ठीक है. और अगर मैं स्पेसिफिक फोल्डर, जैसे अभी यहाँ पे देखिए, मैंने सी ड्राइव के अफ्रीका फोल्डर के अफ्रीका रिसोर्सेस में जाके वो पर्टिकुलर फाइल सेव की है, तो मैं वहां से वो एक्सेस कर सकती. ठीक है. अब अगर मेरे फोटोज न्यू फोल्डर में कॉपी करने हैं तो क्या करूंगी, मैं पिक्चर्स को ओपन करूंगी विंडोज एक्सप्लोरर में से. न्यू फोल्डर यहाँ दिखेगा मुझे, उस पर क्लिक करूंगी. न्यू फोल्डर आएगा, उसमें मैं अपना नाम डालूंगी. तो मैंने यहाँ पे यॉर्क नाम डाला है और मैंने साथ ही साथ ये सर्च करके रखा है कि मुझे फाइल्स, मेरी जेपीजी फाइल्स कहाँ है. उसमें से कंट्रोल और क्लिक का बटन यूज करके और फिर राइट क्लिक करके मैंने कॉपी वाली फाइल्स की है और वो मैंने यहाँ पे जाके पेस्ट कर दी है. नाउ यू कैन सी दोज फाइल्स एंड दीज आर योर असाइनमेंट्स फॉर टुडे. आई बी शेयरिंग इट ऑन द ग्रुप. दीज आर द रेफरेंसेस. आई होप एवरीवन हैज गॉट इट. इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी क्वेरीज, प्लीज पोस्ट ऑन द चैट. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर पेशेंस.